Okay, so let's wrap this up by returning to the core theme that we introduced earlier, which is the idea that information is bits plus context. So you have to know the context for interpreting the bits that you have. Otherwise, you just have useless bits. And so, you know, if we were to think about what does 1011 mean, well, it depends. It depends on what kind of encoding we're using. So if it's an unsigned number, then its decimal value is 11. If we're using signed magnitude, its value is negative 3. If we're using 1's complement, its value is negative 4. And if we're using 2's complement, its value is negative 5. So again, it's very important to know not only the bits that you have, but how you are supposed to interpret those bits. So here is just sort of an overview and a comparison of these different formats. We are going to see one more signed integer encoding next week, and so I've put that off to the right here in gray. So this is what's called an offset or biased encoding. So these are the binary values from 0 up to the highest value. So I've cut out some of the range, but these are sort of the important point places on the number line. So we have for a 1-byte number or an 8-bit number, we have unsigned values from 0 to 255. Here are their values if we are interpreting them as signed magnitude numbers. And you can see that we have positive numbers up through 127, and then 128 is negative 0, and then we sort of decrease in negative or increase in negative value from there. 1's complement is similar, where all the positive numbers are the same as their unsigned value, but 1's complement kind of flips the negative numbers and puts the largest negative number or sort of the smallest, so it's the smallest number, it's the highest absolute value number down at the bottom of the negative range. And then 2's complement is just like that, except that it gets rid of the extra 0 and adds an extra negative number. And so that's sort of a comparison, and you'll notice that in all of these encodings that we've talked about so far, all of the positive numbers, so all the numbers where the first bit, the sign bit, is not set, those are all the same in all four of these representations. So that's an important thing to keep in mind as you're working with them. That's not true in offset. So when we get to that format, you will see that the lower numbers, the ones that have this bit not set, or this bit is 0, those are going to be actually mostly negative numbers. So you'll have to be careful about that. The nice thing about offset notation is that it actually preserves the ordering of all of these numbers. You'll see that all of these in here sort of have a disconnect where we go from a positive number to a negative number as we add 1 in the unsigned representation. And offset doesn't have that problem, so it's nice with from that perspective.